Hello, my name is David Anderson. Welcome to Understanding NHD Drainage Systems. I work as the partner support for Region 6, which is the upper northeast United States, for the National Geospatial Technical Operations Center in Rolla, Missouri. There are many types of drainage systems that are natural within the world. Dendritic is the most common, and that's what you're going to see today as far as what is contained in the NHD. They basically are derived from topography, topology of the area, geology, flow of water, and other items. The NHD allows the end users to visualize these systems almost immediately in most cases and be able to determine what size of the area is being drained by these surface water features. This is a dendritic system that's being shown here. As you can see, it looks kind of like a chain of features going down into the one pore point, which is that green dot up there next to the lake in the upper northeast area. And this is the most common of the drainage systems. Interbasins connections can either be natural or man-made. Karst systems are one of the most common natural ones. They consist of things like sinkholes and springs where the water might disappear into a groundwater system and emerge eventually out at another area. Man-made systems are quite common too because of our public water drinking systems, ditches and canals that are meant to reroute any of the external waters to another area. One of the big ones is Harold E. Roberts Aqueduct off the Dillon Reservoir to Denver, or the Catskill Aqueduct off of the Astrakhan Reservoir in New York City that is used for public water systems. Drainage basins, as far as what is the area of drainage, is contained in the NHD and the WBD feature set. These are what some people like to call hydrologic units, and there are three populated feature classes within the WBD. That's your 8-digit, 10-digit, and 12-digit HUC systems. These basically are the subbasins, watersheds, and subwatersheds that are populated. If you want to find out where the water is coming from or how it's getting to an area, you can use utility network analyst. There's different flags that you can use, such as starts, stops, things like that, that you can trace water. In this screenshot, I'm showing that you can actually trace the flow uphill, and you'll notice that the flow actually extends beyond the little green flags, which is the start and stop of the utility network analyst. And that's because what it's doing is identifying the whole feature where that drainage is coming from. So this is how you would use Utility Network Analyst to map the flow of a specific area that you want to look at.